Good afternoon. Welcome to the Church of the Holy Spirit and the Eucharistic celebration of the fifth Sunday in Ordinary Time. We have a few announcements. Wednesday's devotions will be at Holy Trinity during the month of February. Please come together with your community to enjoy this special afternoon with song and prayer. The parish offices remain closed to all visitors. The office staff will be happy to assist you with your needs via the phone or email. Thank you for your continued support. Ash Wednesday is February 17th. Ashes will be distributed at 8:30 a.m. at Holy Trinity, 12:10 p.m. here at Holy Spirit, and 5:30 p.m. at Holy Trinity. With all our limitations and weaknesses, we come before the God of love, who gives us fullness of life. Our celebrant today is Father Matt Westman.
Thank you. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And together let us praise God's holy name with the glory of glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we give the Lord upon you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, Son of God, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy God, Son.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, 'When shall I arise?' then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again." The word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord who heals the broken hearted. Praise the Lord who heals the broken hearted. I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed upon me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense, but if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak I became weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least one. And this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On the contrary, the fact that he lamented the way that he did was actually, in so many ways, a sign that, yes, God was listening to him. And when you think about this, the book of Psalms, of the 150 Psalms, about a third of them are Psalms, are Psalms of lament. And there may be times when we read the Psalms that we can say, you know, even if I can't necessarily relate to the exact words that are being that are said here, I can relate to feeling anxious, to struggling, to feeling hopelessness, to even feeling even feeling depression to a certain extent, maybe a little bit, or in some cases a lot. And so that we can consider Psalm 22, the psalm that Jesus himself says while he is on the cross, my God, why have you forsaken me? Yes, the psalm itself is a psalm that is heart-wrenching, difficult to listen to, difficult to read. But thankfully, though, at the end, it also reminds us that even when we complain, even when we lament, we do trust we are not saying those words to an empty audience, so to speak, but rather God is there. God is there to listen to us, and God is there to catch us, so to speak. Today's gospel reading, taken from Mark, reminds us that, yes, Jesus came to us 2,000 years ago to bring healing. And Jesus' people clearly needed healing for various reasons. Here the sick came to him. Those possessed by various kinds of demons came to him. And he helped them. He healed them. He drove out the demons. And when he did that, he did it as a sign of the coming of the kingdom of God in their midst. A sign that, yes, when God dwells with his people, all will be well once more. And there will be a sense of restoration of order, and that will be a very good thing. For us today, too, we probably also wonder, at least from time to time, maybe, or in some cases, more often than time to time, when will we leave this land of exile, so to speak? For many people, the year 2020 was incredibly difficult, heartbreaking in many cases. There were so many people who lost jobs or had their hours reduced. People who literally deal with the symptoms of COVID-19, the coronavirus, head on. And as we, of course, we know, looking at the statistics throughout our country, over 400,000 people have passed. And so, therefore, the year 2020 was difficult. It was heartbreaking. And in so many ways, there are people out there who, when they reflect upon all that we have lost, they might say, yeah, Joe, I think you have a point there. We toss and turn at night, and we wonder what is going to happen. And yet, at the same time, even if there are quite a few songs of lament, even if there is an entire book in the Hebrew Scriptures called Lamentations, despite all of these outward sighs, these outward groanings, we also do trust that somehow God will make things right. We also do trust that God is amongst us. The same Jesus who went from town to town and he healed the sick, he cast out demons, is with us today too in spirit. He is here, and in so many ways, we have opportunities to be able to be reminded of that. There are so many good people out there who have used their positions of leadership and power to be able to do good things in their communities, to be able to help those who are in trouble. Even just locally here, I'm so amazed at all the good work that is done here at Fulton County. The various food pantries that's here, one here in Gloversville in particular, as well as at St. John's Episcopal Church in Johnstown, the good work that is carried out at the Helpers Community Store down the street here on South Main Street, ourselves can identify almost occasionally with the words of Job, even if sometimes we wonder when will we be delivered from this, these hardships, we also understand that God is with us. We may not always understand why we go through these times, but God is with us indeed. And as Jesus healed the people 2,000 years ago, he also yearns to heal us as well and to allow us to know that, yes, for this purpose he has come to be with his people, to be with us.
Lord, hear our prayer. For those
some of her languid supper presented, he took the chalice, and when once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we
in one bread and one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, thank you for joining us today for this liturgy. Certainly wish all of you a very blessed rest of the day today, a very blessed weekend. The Lord be with you.
I know, right?
You're on the wall.
I took them here.
You know,
just coming to church and just standing at the pulpit and it's just empty now. It's just very hard.
It is hard for me too, because I don't like it, like just see that people coming all over so people can come back.
Right. I wonder if people will come back.
I think
in due time.
They will. In due time, yeah. When the fear is done. You know. It's just like
a catch.
I don't know. The whole thing is just so so sad. Yeah. And like we saw your father there 3 weeks ago.
It is.
I know.
I mean, the employer obviously had probably
a health problem. He did. But we didn't realize that he had congestive heart failure. My one friend said to me, she goes, Rita, how long has he had congestive? Because she's a nurse. And I'm like,
no.
She goes, he did have COVID in one room. Probably we're waiting the next couple of months, and if you and me are like that, we'll have found him, because we're always going next door, you know?
Right.
So, not that I'm glad. I just know he didn't want to be here anymore.
And you didn't want him to suffer.
No. Mm-hmm. I'd go to work sometimes, and I would say, are you back? And I'd say, I wish God would just take him.
We're good.
Oh,
good.
Yes.